Hello, I'm Richard, your senior network engineer from Zyxel Networks, and welcome to the episode 2 of our Tech Talk. In this video, I will introduce the current mainstream wireless protocols, Wi-Fi 6 and Wi-Fi 6E, and how they improve the wireless communication. So whether you are looking to upgrade your existing network devices, or simply interested in the latest Wi-Fi technology, and this video can help you to make the purchasing decisions or continue to delve deeper into technologies that interest you. And now, let's get the talk started. So wireless technology has gone through many iterations. Starting in 2003, Wi-Fi 3, 4, and 5 were developed. And in 2020, the latest Wi-Fi protocol, Wi-Fi 6, was introduced. And firstly, we need to understand that when each protocol is established and there is a problem to be solved or a user scenario to be met at that time. So prior to Wi-Fi 6, the goal was to improve Wi-Fi transmission speed. At that time, people's expectation for Wi-Fi were to smoothly browse the web and download a file as quickly as possible. And therefore, improving the speed can most directly enhance the user experience. And after developing for 20 years, the available wireless transmission rate increased from 54 megabit per second to 1.3 gigabit per second, and make Wi-Fi a popular and necessary function. For example, we can use social media through Wi-Fi in the cafe, restaurant, and hotels. And in the office, a Wi-Fi also gradually replaces the wired cable, being able to fulfill enterprise daily operation needs. Without saying, we are also use Wi-Fi at home, on our smartphones, and even the smart TV. As the time goes by, Wi-Fi have gone from nice to have to a must to have technology. Although the 1.3 gigabit per second transmission rate seems catch up with the wired connections, the way signal transmitted in Wi-Fi is different from that in wired connections. In wired transmission, each device has its own dedicated line. Comparing to that, all Wi-Fi devices share a single channel, and only one device can transmit at a time, like many vehicles going to merge into the same lane on the road. In the case mentioned above, we need a mechanism or a traffic light to ensure that everyone can access the channel smoothly without collision or accident. And therefore, a mechanism called CSMACA is established, which defines that a data can be transmitted only when there is no traffic for a short while. So which is like the traffic light, and making devices access the channel one by one. Although the CSMACA provides the traffic rule in the channel access, it also brings out a disadvantage. As more devices want to access the channel, the waiting time for each device also increases. So just like the traffic jam in our daily life, which degrades Wi-Fi using experience. Like we have said, in the past, people used Wi-Fi to browse web pages, send and receive files. And therefore, these delays and waiting time were still acceptable, because people can do other things when the page is loading or the file is transferring. However, now many devices are using Wi-Fi for streaming service, instant calls, health and body monitoring. These applications do not transmit large amounts of data, but their tolerance for the delay is much lower. And therefore, when the congestion occurs, people will find that the video is always buffering, the call is interrupted, or the system information is not updated. So the service impact of congestion has become critical, indicates that a new technology is needed to solve the issue. And after noticing the issue mentioned, and the transmission problem of Wi-Fi has changed from the insufficient rate to insufficient capacity, which is to reduce the waiting time for these applications that requires lower latency. And this is the issue that Wi-Fi 6 trying to solve. To solve the problem of insufficient capacity, Wi-Fi 6 adopts a new access method called OFDMA, which is the acronym of the Orthogonal Frequency Division Multiple Access. In the OFDMA, a single channel is divided into many partitions called Resource Unit, RU, which allows multiple devices to access the channel simultaneously, and thus significantly reduce the waiting time for each of them. At the same time, these RUs can be dynamically combined and allocated to cope with different data size and applications. And therefore, whether it is an IoT device upgrading the monitor information, which requires smaller spaces, or a laptop that watching the streaming video and refer to the larger data spaces, both of them can access the channel promptly and maintain the sufficient speed without long waiting time, like the behavior in the previous standard. With the OFDMA, the problem of the network congestion can be effectively addressed. This allows Wi-Fi 6 to better accommodate the growing amount of client devices today, as well as more real-time applications. In addition to the improvement in the channel access method, Wi-Fi 6 has also made progress in the way of utilizing the antenna, named MU MIMO, which is the acronym of Multi-User, Multiple Input, Multiple Output. As early as the Wi-Fi 5 era, the MU MIMO has been developed, which could allow access point with multiple antennas to transmit the data to different devices instead of one device at a time, and increasing the utilization of the antenna usage. However, at that time, this technology could only be used for the download traffic, which is from the access point to the wireless devices. On the other hand, for the offload traffic, if multiple devices want to transmit the data to access point at the same time, they still need to take turns for uploading, and the access point cannot fully utilize its antenna for the Wi-Fi service and might cause some user unsatisfied. And therefore, Wi-Fi 6 applies MU MIMO to the upload traffic as well, and hence access point can fully utilize its antenna on both download and the upload traffic. Each client device can also shorten their waiting period and reduce the service impact caused by traffic congestion and the long waiting time. By applying NU MIMO to the upload traffic, access point can handle applications that requires higher data amount more efficiently, while the OFDMA focus on the partition of a single channel. So when a client device requires higher data amount traffic, it may still occupy the entire bandwidth. So the use of multiple antennas can avoid the upload traffic monopolize a single channel, and other device can still use other antennas to transmit. And therefore, in office or our home, the impact when a device is uploading a large data file can be reduced. Talking about other enhancements in Wi-Fi 6, the point we must mention is the maximized wireless speed has also increased, with wider bandwidth and more MIMO antennas supported. And besides, the stronger modulation technology called 1024 QAM is adopted. All these technologies push the peak data rate to 9.6 gigabit per second in the Wi-Fi 6. And this performance opens up more possibility for the Wi-Fi, such as transmitting 4K or 8K videos, gaming, and even on AR or VR. things that used to require the cable connection can now be solved through the wireless, and bringing a lot of convenience to people. After understanding Wi-Fi 6, and let's turn to introduce the Wi-Fi 6E. In fact, Wi-Fi 6E is based on the same wireless standard as Wi-Fi 6, which is 802.11ax. The only difference is Wi-Fi 6E extends the technology to a new released wireless band, which is located at 6 GHz. So many benefits of Wi-Fi 6E is driven from the usage of this new service band. The biggest advantage of this service band is all devices here are operating Wi-Fi 6E, which making like a wireless transmission highway. So thinking about it, in 2.4 or 5 GHz band, there are lots of devices supporting Wi-Fi 4 or Wi-Fi 5 with lower maximized data rate. So the entire Wi-Fi performance will be degraded by those outdated devices. On the other hand, this scenario won't happen on 6 GHz band, and all the devices can operate at the fastest speed in this interference-free environment. Another benefit of 6 GHz band is it provides 2 times the available bandwidth of 5 GHz. So with the wider bandwidth, network administrator can get higher flexibility to allocate their access points into different non-overlapping channels, which can ensure APs won't interfere each other. So for places where intensive deployment is required, like office, it will be easy to keep the overall Wi-Fi throughput in a higher level, which also lays to the foundation for Wi-Fi 7 in 2024. When a new protocol is released, access points are usually launched to the market earlier than the client device. So when a Wi-Fi 6 AP was launched, most client devices were still remain in Wi-Fi 5 capability. As for now, Wi-Fi 6 has been published for several years, and the supported client device has just come onto the market. And also noted that few Wi-Fi 6E devices is coming to the market as well. So talking about Zyxel Network's latest Wi-Fi 6 product, we have the NWA50X Pro, which provides all the benefit we mentioned earlier regarding Wi-Fi 6. And the device itself can provide a maximum cumulative rate of 3 gigabit per second. On top of that, the proprietary hardware design can filter the interference from the cellular network. So whether you are at home, in the office, or on a public hotspot, we recommend this device for you to keep your Wi-Fi service smooth and fast. If you want to plan ahead for the future and deploy access points that support Wi-Fi 6E, Zyxel Networks offer the NWA220AX-6E. So in addition to supporting the latest protocol, the biggest highlight of this product is in its radio design called BandFlex. So which support either 5 GHz or 6 GHz through the configuration, and making it the most cost-effective option to fit into your existing 5 GHz coverage, while also future-proofing the use of 6 GHz. So at current stage, you can use 5 GHz radio. And in the future, as the number of Wi-Fi 6E devices growing up, you can switch the radio to use 6 GHz and allowing your client to enjoy the ultimate performance in 6 GHz radio. Another point worth highlight is regarding to the device management. Zyxel Networks offer a cloud management solution called Nebula. So within few steps, you can monitor and manage your wireless network anytime, anywhere, and don't need to directly access your device. And if there is any network issue occurred, you will be informed immediately through our app. So the platform is fully functional and offers flexible upgrade service. So checking our education center to find more benefits of the Nebula solution. And if you are interested in our products, visit the Zyxel store or click the link below to find the closest purchase point. In today's video, we learn about the development of the Wi-Fi standards and the changing demands in the progress. We also introduce the advanced technologies in Wi-Fi 6, including OFDMA, MU MIMO on the uplink traffic, and other technologies to increase the speed. Additionally, we explain the background of Wi-Fi 6E and provide some purchasing suggestions for those who want to upgrade their network devices. If you enjoy our video, please like and subscribe, and visit our education center for more training videos. I'm Richard, see you next time. Bye-bye.
We're Zyxel, and we're your networking ally.